Everyone, this is Yamin and welcome to Laravel HTML management system project. Now in the previous tutorial we added this remove button so that user can delete data from the cart or remove data from the cart. Now in this tutorial we're going to add a order now button over here, and if the user click the order now button, then some input field will show, and the input field will contain name, address and phone number, and user can confirm their order. Okay, so let's go back to our code. We'll directly go to our showcart.bread.php, and over here just below this table ending we'll declare a div, and this div will be align center. Align will be center, and let's also see our hair style. Padding will be 10px. Now padding create gap. Okay, so we'll add a button over here, and this button name will be order now. And now let's just add a class over here so that the button looks a little better. So we'll say btn primary. So let's save it, control s. Now if we refresh over here, we'll see a button in the middle, in the center. So over here you can see a button. Now if you click this button, some input field will show. So now let's create some input field over here. So we'll create another div over here. We'll say div, and inside this div we are going to mention another div, and over here we are going to say level. Label will be name. After name we'll say input. Input type will be text. Name is equal to name, and let's also add a placeholder. Placeholder will be name. Now let's also add a style over here. Let's say style means padding. We'll say padding 10px. Okay, so let's just copy it, and I will paste it two times. This one will be for address, phone number, and this one will be for address. So over here we'll say phone first. Number input type will be number. Name is equal to, it will be number, number, or let's say phone, and placeholder will be phone number. Okay, after phone number we'll say address. Address, so input type will be text, that's fine, and name will be address, and placeholder let's say it will be AWRES address as well. So let's also add a submit button. So we don't require name over here. We also don't require placeholder or name for submit button. So input type will be submit, and let's also add a value. Let's say over here order confirm. Order confirm, let's also add a bootstrap class, bootstrap button class. So for it we will say class btn we'll say success. So let's save it, control s. Now okay, one more thing, let's add over here align center, and style let's say style, let's say padding 10px. Okay, so let's save it, and let's refresh over here. So over here you can see name, phone and address option. Over here you can make it looks a little bit better if you want, but for now that's fine. Now we'll add some JavaScript code over here. So for this, first of all we need to add a jQuery CDN in our code. So for adding jQuery CDN, just search for jQuery CDN, press enter, and you will see something like this. Just go to over here, jQuery get started w3 school. Just click over here, and if you go down you'll see over here Google CDN. This is actually jQuery CDN, so we are just going to copy this script. So control c, and we'll paste it inside our head code set. So let's go to our code, and over here you can see over here our heads ins here. So we'll paste our CDN link over here. So let's save it. I'll also give this skip in the description so that you can directly copy it from there. So now let's start writing our JavaScript. So first of all, we need to declare an ID over here in the order now button. So over here ID will be order, and in this div we also need to add a ID as well. So let's say over here ID, let's say over here ID name will be appear, okay, appear. Okay, so let's save it, and now we'll directly go to our script part, and over here we'll just say over here script, and inside this script we are going to write some JavaScript code over here. So first of all, over here you can see that I added an ID over here. ID is equal to order, right? So first of all, we are going to just say over here dollar, then first bracket, then two double quotation, and inside it we are going to say hash order. Then we'll say over here dot click. It means if someone click that button, then we will run this function. So we'll end this with a semicolon. So we'll say over here function, then to second bracket, and over here we are going to write one more line, and that is if someone click the order now button, then this will this thing will show. Okay, now over here you can see that we mentioned ID is equal to appear, right? So we are just going to say over here dollar, then first bracket, then two double quotation, then hash appear. We are going to say over here dot show, right? So let's save it, control S. Now the thing is, let's just refresh. Now the thing is, those input field is already showing. If you click order now, these are already showing, right? So what we are going to do is that we are just going to say in this div, in the style tag, we'll say display none. So what will happen is that so let's save it. Now if we refresh over here, you can see that there is no input field over here. Now if we click order now, here you can see that you can see the input field right now. Now what we should do, one more thing, is that we should add a close button over here so that user can close it if they don't want to confirm their order. Okay, so let's add another close button over here. So I'm just going to add a button just over here. I'll just say over here button. Let's say over here close, or you can say cancel. So I'll just say class btn danger. So we also need to mention an ID for this close button, so we'll just say over here close. Okay, so let's save it, control S. Now we are just going to copy this, control C, and we'll just paste it over here again, and instead of order this time we'll say close. And now instead of show appear dot show, we'll say over here height. So let's save it, control S. Now let's refresh. Now over here in the beginning there is no input field. If we click order now, the input field is showing. Now if we click close, you can see that those are gone. So now in the next tutorial we'll do the order confirm part. If the user click the order confirm, then all the data will be uploaded in the database and the admin can see who ordered the food. Okay, so this is all for this tutorial, and thank you very much for watching. And if you like this video, please give a like to the video, and if you want to show appreciation, then subscribe my channel, and thanks again for watching.